Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to Lightning Gaming. So in today's episode I'm gonna show you the top spear build you can get in all of 7 days to die. This build is so overpowered guys, you can clear the whole Red Mesa compound, which is one of the hardest military compounds in all of 7 days to die. You can clear it within 6 minutes by simply running in and spearing all the zombies to death. As you can see, this is one of the hardest parts. And it didn't even take me 30 seconds to clear this whole thing out. But you're gonna need some special modifications. You're gonna need a special skill set. And then also you're gonna need some special armor. In this video I will show you a full guide to how to get all of that. To get the most out of a spear build. And yeah, you can simply become unstoppable with this build. So let's jump straight into the build. Let me show you how you can get there. Okay, so first things first, the spear, you're gonna use the steel spear. As you can see, after modifications, 55% damage. Now, weighted head mod, this gives you some extra damage. And it stuns and slow your victims. And then the grip mod is also very important. It decreases melee stamina usage. And then the books you're gonna need. You're gonna need the whole Spear Hunter collection. Each has their own benefits and perks. Then for the food, you're gonna use beer for that stamina regeneration. Very important. And also stun resistance. Now let me head over to the skills. Okay, so the most important skill guys, perception, have to be 10 out of 10. You're gonna need Spear Master, 5 out of 5. And then quick and perceptive, you're gonna need 3 out of 3. That's the most important. If you have extra skill points, head over to Fortitude, put 10 out of 10 into Fortitude. Pain Tolerance, 5 out of 5. Healing Factor, 5 out of 5. And Rule 1 Cardio, 3 out of 3. Then agility, 10 out of 10. Medium armor, you're gonna go 4 out of 4. And parkour, 4 out of 4. Now remember guys, these skills are only if you have extra points. But the perceptive is the most important. Now for our armor, biker gloves gives us melee damage 60%. Biker boots, reduced melee stamina usage, minus 20%. Then the outfit, extra max health. And the helmet gives you stun resistance 20%. Now guys, when you go out and you go to the POI that you want to clear, only thing important about this build is you have to keep an open space. This thing will knock tons of enemies down that's close to each other with the special perks you got. And then also, yeah, as you can see, even the most powerful zombies take like 3 hits at most to destroy. And right now I'm in the Red Mesa military compound. I'm gonna skip to the end where it's the most difficult part of this whole POI. I would say this is the most difficult POI in all of 7 days to die. I know some people think otherwise, but yeah. Let me skip to the end and show you how this thing works in the most hardest places in this POI. Now check this out guys, this is single-handedly one of the most difficult parts in all of 7 days to die. But now look at it. You just go through them like it's nothing. You just hit for the head, the ragdoll, and they will die so quick that yeah, that it makes you really unstoppable. With this build you don't even need the horde base, you can just run around, kill the entire horde the whole time. So if you want to change your game a little bit, if you want to try something new, go for the spear build guys, you won't regret it. Thank you so much for watching guys, if you enjoyed the video, please remember to give us a like and hit that subscribe button. You guys been supporting us so good, we're almost on 3000 subscribers already for a new channel, that's great. We'll continue making content, dropping tips and glitches and everything you need to know about all your favorite survival games. So please remember to hit that subscribe button. Till next time guys, thank you for the support. Cheers, see ya.